dealt it for Eliash. Off the corner bounce, he's sent to the glass by Laflamme. And it's taken by Xavier Dalil.
Nice enunciation.
Rapalski. Oh, thank you, sir. Once in a while I get lucky, and I'm not so sure that our French-Canadian friends who are watching would still agree.
There's going to be a few broadcasters that butcher that name early in the season, I'm afraid.
They won't forget his number, though. 88. Stevens, Rapalski. Stevens. Work back ahead now for Kelly. Handed on to Bobby Holik, then Mogilny. Kelly was fidgeting with Dalil, who took him down so that Savage can start back. The horn sounds and the scoreboard is going nuts. It's flashing as a score is registered by Kelly. I don't know if a whistle had blown.
Well, let's hope it hasn't. Let's hope the goal stands, because Steve Kelly had a wonderful training camp, put some pucks in the net. Here's a kid with great speed. He was a first round pick. All he lacks is a scoring touch, but you wouldn't know it by this play. Now remember, the clock is going bananas. There's eights all over the clock. It's sounding the alarm, but for some reason the play continued. Nice play by the Devils here. Beautiful move by Steve Kelly.
I would gather that there had been no whistle because they all continued to play. And it's not such a deafening crowd right now, with many of the fans having left, that you would think it would cancel out. Excuse me for interrupting you there, Chico, but I've got a feeling this one's going to stick because no whistle was blown.
Yeah, you're right, Mike. It's going to stand. It's interesting. As soon as the goal was scored, the clock righted itself at the proper time, 3.09 seconds left, and the score came back. But through that whole sequence, it was going crazy. Now watch here, watch 43 right here. Oh, Brisbois is trying to get the attention of the linesman or the referee, and he continues even after the goal score. I see now why he's so far out of position.
You know, Chico, the league at the time that you and I came through at the old IHL, we would have thought that would have been a conspiracy and that it was just one of the other ploys that you would run into to try and throw a team off. But here it was totally by accident. Yet the officials kept their focus, did not both play dead, and so the Kelly goal stands.
Alain Vigneault wants an explanation, and I'm sure Andy Van Helemon will be reviewing this particular play. And it was a strange call. I could see both sides. Yeah, Doc, in the minor leagues, the team extended beyond the player's bench.
Oh, yeah.
It extended over to the timekeeper's bench. And a lot of shenanigans used to take place in the minor leagues that would always seem to favor the home team.
Yeah, some of them behind you in Muskegon, Michigan.
Where, oh, no
where,
way.
Where the coach's brother-in-law was one of the goal judges and would raise his arms after he turned the light on to celebrate the goal himself. Anyway, here's...